as you saw in that intro, today I'll be reviewing the iPad mini first generation. Yeah, so this is gonna be a full review of the iPad mini first generation. This was like one of the first iPad minis. Yeah, it is the first iPad mini. It was given to the people in November 2012, but unveiled in October 2012. So it packs in a 7.9 inch display with just about 720p pixels, measuring 768 by 1024 pixels, which gives us a PPI of 162. It has a 512 RAM, three capacities, 16, 32 and 64 gigabyte. I have the 16 gigabyte silver and white iPad mini. I know this is very old, but I didn't have anything else, so I started making this video. So yeah, so let's get started with the specs. So it has a Apple designed A5 chipset with a 4490 milliamp hour battery, with a 5 megapixel autofocus rear camera and a 1.2 megapixel front facing camera. The back camera can record videos in 1080p up to 30 frames per second, and the front can record it up in 720p up to 30 frames per second. So what I like about this iPad is its thin profile. It's very thin, as I explained in my Ben test review in my first channel. It's really thin and it's light. That's why I love to carry it everywhere. Its camera sensor is pretty good too. Let me show you the camera sensor. So this is the camera. Front camera is very nice. I love the front camera quality. So let me get into focus. Yeah, so it has burst mode, is pretty fast. HDR processing is fast too. Timer mode, 1 seconds, 3 seconds or 10 seconds. And switch off the timer, off. Then it has few more modes like photo, I was in square, photo, video when you record in primary. If you want 1080p quality, just double tap it. Yeah, so this 1080p quality, and just double tap it again to bring the same 720p quality. Front camera, double tap it to bring 720p at 30 frames per second quality, or just double tap it to bring 540p. So it has a new feature called time lapse, which is really good. So for example, I'll show you a time lapse now. Time lapse takes a bit time to come and process, so it's done here. So let me show you what. It increases the speed of it. As I gave you this example, it's a beast actually. Time lapse is really good. So let me unlock it. So let me show you what's on my iPad. First of all, we've got FaceTime, which is built in. Then we got calendar, photos, camera, contacts, clock, navigation. I got Apple's built-in maps, which is useless in India, and Google Maps. Videos, which is pre-installed, notes, reminders, photo booth, which is also pre-installed from iOS 6, Game Center, Newsstand, iTunes Store, App Store, settings, and some Apple apps, books, iBooks, which I downloaded, Find My iPhone, podcast and tips got pre-installed when we installed iOS 8. We got Twitter here, Amazon, Facebook Messenger and Facebook, YouTube, Capture, YouTube and Studio, which is very helpful. We got Yahoo apps, sports and weather, which are very handy, and they have their own widgets. Let me show you later. Then games, I've got some swing copters, Tap Dart, Sudoku, 2048, which is really addictive. Love playing it. Photography, I got Instagram. I'll leave a link to my Instagram username in the description below. Patgram, Slowpro, Hyperlapse by Instagram, and VSCO Cam, which is a good video editing software, and we got calculator, as they don't include any. Here down we've got messages, mail, Safari and music. So let me show you the widgets. It's here, no events, so it's not showing up today. Weather, sports, 59 degrees, sports, there are no sports scores, but there's still El Clasico tomorrow. I don't know why it's not showing me that. So down scroll, you get the menu, notification bar, and if you scroll up, you get the control center, which everybody is aware of. I don't keep the brightness high because you get the idea, right? It decreases your battery life. Yeah, so here we've got clock, the clock app opens, or the timer, and the camera app opens here. So what we've got here is the music and AirDrop, which is a new feature. Here we've got airplane mode, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, do not disturb, and mute switch. And this is, the mute switch can be configurable for portrait or landscape lock mode. If you choose landscape, it'll be mute, and if you choose mute in the settings, it'll be landscape, so portrait and lock. So let me show you the hardware then. So 7.9-inch display, the iPad mini. It has a home button, little square. It has a home button with a small square inside. I like the home button. It's convex, I guess, so you don't have to just go around like this, you can feel it. On the bottom we've got the speaker grills, lightning connector, and another speaker grills. Actually, the left one is the stereo speakers, and the right one, the effect just echoes into this. On the left hand side we've got nothing, absolutely nothing. On the top we've got a FaceTime HD camera. And on above the FaceTime HD camera, we got the sleep wake button, a microphone, and a headphone jack. This is a Wi-Fi version, so you don't get that black padding. And here we've got the portation lock switch. So you can see it's locked now. Lock, unlock. And we've got the volume rockers. On the back, we've got that highly reflective Apple logo, iPad symbol, I mean the trademark Apple font on the back, and the 5 megapixel primary camera. So guys, thanks for watching the iPad mini review. Hope you guys liked it. Go ahead and sub to this channel, as this is a startup and new channel, and go ahead and sub to my first channel too. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. I appreciate it.